All right, let's talk about one of the most important, but maybe one of the most overlooked parts of the financial world, the bond market. Because believe it or not, hidden in plain sight right there is a powerful message, a clue about the future of our entire economy. And today, we're going to figure out how to read it. You know, we all feel the sting of inflation, right? Prices go up, your money just doesn't stretch as far. But what if you could see it coming? I mean, really see it coming. What if there was some kind of financial crystal ball that could actually predict it?
Seriously, think about that for a second. The folks at the very top, you know, the ones running entire economies, they have to know what's on the horizon. So how did they do it? How in the world did they get a reliable forecast for something that feels as unpredictable as future inflation?
Well, it might sound a little strange, but the answer isn't tucked away in some super complex economic model locked in a vault. Nope. It's right out there in the open, broadcast every single day by what you could call the collective wisdom of thousands and thousands of investors. And it's all happening in the bond market. Today, we're going to learn how to read that signal. So to decode this message, we've got to meet the two main characters in our little story. We're talking about two different kinds of government bonds. On the surface, they look pretty similar, but trust me, they tell completely different stories about where the future is headed. Okay, so here's the core difference, and it's a big one. On one side, you have your standard government bond. It pays you a fixed, totally predictable amount. Simple enough. But on the other side, you've got this thing called an indexed linked bond. And this one is special. Its payments actually grow with inflation. The whole point is to protect the value of your money. So one is vulnerable to inflation, and the other is basically designed to be inflation-proof. So how does this inflation-proof bond actually work? I mean, how can a piece of paper just magically shield your investment from rising prices? It sounds kind of wild, right? Well, let's break it down with a really simple example. Let's just imagine you buy a special government bond, okay? And it promises to pay you, say, $5 in interest every single year. But here's the key. This isn't a normal bond. It's one of those index-linked ones. Okay, now this is where the magic really happens. The initial promise is $5, but then bam, inflation hits, and it hits hard. Let's say 10%. Now with a normal bond, your $5 is suddenly worth less. Its buying power is down. But with this bond, the payment itself adjusts. It automatically grows by that 10% to $5.50, perfectly matching inflation. Your purchasing power is totally preserved. Pretty cool, huh?
All right, so we've got our two key players, the standard bond and the inflation-proof bond. Now we're ready. By putting these two side by side, we can finally uncover that hidden message the market is sending us.
So let's pretend we're going to the market. The government is offering two bonds. Now, these bonds are identical in almost every single way. They both mature in 1 year. They're both considered totally risk-free. The only difference is that one is linked to inflation and the other is not.
First up, let's look at the standard, non-linked bond. The market is offering a yield of 11%. It's a straightforward, what we call nominal return. You put your money in and you get 11% back in a year. Simple. Okay, now let's look at the index-linked bond. The market is offering a yield of just 4.5%. Now, this is a real return, which means you get 4.5% plus whatever inflation ends up being. But just looking at the numbers, 4.5% looks a lot less exciting than 11%, doesn't it?
And that right there is the big question. Why would any rational investor take a 4.5% return when they could get 11% on an investment that's just as safe? What is going on? What's hiding inside that massive gap between those two numbers?
And here it is, the big reveal. That gap, that's the hidden message. It's what economists call inflation expectations. The difference between that 11% nominal yield and the 4.5% real yield, that is the market's collective bet on what inflation is going to be. So in this case, the market is essentially saying, we think inflation is going to be about 6.5%. That's why the standard bond has to pay so much extra, just to compensate for the inflation it isn't protected from.
And listen, this isn't just some abstract economic theory. This is a real tool used by the world's most powerful financial institutions. I mean, central banks literally look at this data because, as the source material says, it taps into the wisdom of the crowds. Why rely on a handful of economists in a room when you can see what thousands of investors are betting on with their own real money? It's as close to a real-life crystal ball as they can get.
So, you see,
This isn't just some interesting number for economists to geek out on. It's a powerful signal that can help you, yes, you, understand what's happening in the economy and maybe even make some smarter financial decisions for yourself.
And this table lays out the strategy perfectly. Look, if you personally think inflation is going to be higher than what the market expects, in this case, 6.22%, then that index-linked bond is looking like a really good deal for you. But if you think inflation is going to be much lower than that, say only 2%, then you'd be better off with a standard bond and its higher fixed payout. And what if you think the market got it exactly right? Well, then it really doesn't matter which one you choose. You'd be indifferent. Now, this signal from the market isn't set in stone. It's alive, it's dynamic, it changes every single day based on what's happening in the world. So let's walk through a quick real-world kind of scenario to see exactly how this all plays out in real time. Okay, picture this. Some major event happens out of nowhere. A war breaks out, and suddenly oil prices are skyrocketing. Instantly, everyone starts to worry about higher inflation coming down the pipe. So what happens next? Investors rush to buy the safety of those inflation-proofed index-linked bonds. All that demand pushes their price up, which means their yield goes down. At the same time, people start selling off the standard bonds, so their price falls and their yield goes up. And just like that, the gap between the two yields gets wider, sending a brand new, crystal clear message: the market is now expecting much higher inflation. All right, so let's do a super quick recap. Point one, there are two main types of government bonds, the standard ones and the index-linked ones. Point two, that index-linked bond is your shield against inflation. Point three, the gap in the yields between these two bonds, that's the market's hidden forecast for inflation. And finally, point four, understanding this gap is a powerful tool that lets you tap into that wisdom of the crowds and make smarter decisions.
So there you have it. We've cracked the code. You now know how to read a signal that central bankers and the world's top investors use every single day to try and get a glimpse of the economic future. The only question left is, now that you have this knowledge, what's your next move going to be?
Hey there, and welcome. So today, we're going to be code breakers. Yep, you heard that right. We're going to crack a secret message that the financial markets are sending out like every single day. And this isn't just any message. It's one that helps predict the future.
I know. It sounds like something straight out of a sci-fi movie, right? But what if I told you there's a surprisingly simple way to peek into the collective mind of the economy, to know what millions of investors, companies, and just regular people think is going to happen with one of the most important numbers out there, inflation?
All right, let's get right into it. The bond market, you know, that thing a lot of people think is super complicated? Well, it's actually broadcasting this really powerful signal. It's basically a daily public forecast of where inflation is going. And the best part? Once you learn the language, it's crystal clear.
So where do we actually find this secret message? Well, the clues are hidden in plain sight. Seriously. To crack the code, all we have to do is look at two different kinds of government bonds and just listen to the two very different stories they're telling us.
So let's set this up. Think of it like a tale of two investments. In one corner, we've got something called a nominal bond. And in the other corner, an index bond. They might sound kind of the same, but trust me, the promises they make couldn't be more different. And that difference, well, that's where the magic happens. Okay, so picture yourself as an investor. Here's the choice in front of you. The nominal bond makes a really simple promise. Hey, give you money for a year and I'll guarantee you an 11% return. Sounds pretty good, right? But here's the catch. Its big weakness is inflation. Then you've got the indexed bond. Think of this one as your insurance policy. It offers a lower return up front, only 4.5%, but, and this is a huge but, it promises to tack on whatever the inflation rate is. So your money is basically shielded.
Which, of course, brings up the big question, right? I mean, why in the world would anyone choose the bond that's only offering 4.5% when there's an 11% option sitting right there? At first glance, it looks like a no-brainer and a really bad deal.
Well, funny enough, the answer to that exact question is the key. It's what unlocks this whole secret code. That gap, that difference between those two numbers, it's not a mistake. It's not an accident. It is the message.
And this whole thing works because of this really cool concept called the wisdom of the crowds. The basic idea is that if you get a huge group of different people all guessing at something, their collective average guess is almost always more accurate than what any single expert could come up with. And believe me, the global bond market, that's about as big and as smart a crowd as you can possibly get.
So here's the aha moment. In a free market where millions of people can choose to buy either one of these bonds, things eventually find a balance. And that difference, that gap between the 11% and the 4.5%, that's basically the price the market has decided to put on inflation insurance. It is the crowd's collective bet on what inflation is going to be.
Okay, so how do we actually decode it? It's a super simple three-step formula. First, you start with that simple promise, the 11% yield from the nominal bond. Step two, you subtract the guaranteed part of the index bond's return. And step three, that difference, the number you're left with, that's it. That's the market's hidden prediction for inflation.
And look, this isn't just some fun little thought experiment. This is a tool that's used at the highest levels of finance and government. You know, economists can make all the forecasts they want, but this number, this reflects the actual real-time decisions of millions of people putting their money where their mouth is. In fact, our source material points out that central banks, like the Bank of Israel, literally go to the market to see what the public thinks is on the horizon.
So, let's do the math. What does the code actually say? It's simple, right? You take that 11%, you subtract the 4.5%, and okay, that gets you 6.5%. But once you account for a few other little market quirks, the market's true, precise signal is 6.22%.
And that number, 6.22%, that's the magic number. It's what we call the break-even point. It's the exact rate of inflation where it wouldn't matter which bond you picked, you'd get the same return either way. It's the wisdom of that giant crowd all boiled down to one single incredibly powerful number.
All right, so we've done it. We cracked the code. We know what the market is thinking. But here's where it gets really cool. Now you can take this information and actually use it to make your own calls.
So let me ask you straight up. You have the secret number now. You know the market is betting on 6.22% inflation. If this was your money on the line, which bond are you buying?
Well, your choice boils down to one simple thing. Do you agree with the crowd or not? Let's say you think inflation is going to be way higher than 6.22%. I don't know, say 10%. In that case, the index bond is a slam dunk. Your total return would be 14.5%, which blows that 11% out of the water. But what if you think the market is being way too worried? What if you think inflation will be super low, like 2%? Then you'd definitely go for the nominal bond. Its 11% return would completely crush the 6.5% you'd get from the other one.
And what makes this so fascinating, what makes it so powerful, is that this isn't some static number that comes out once a quarter. No, this thing is alive. It's constantly changing, minute by minute, acting like a live, real-time pulse of the economy's hopes and fears.
Let's run through a quick example from the source material to see exactly how this plays out. So imagine some huge global event happens out of the blue. A war breaks out, and boom, oil prices just go through the roof.
Instantly, what's the one thought that flashes through every investor's mind, from the huge hedge funds down to the person trading on their phone? It's the same thing. Oh man, this is going to make inflation spike.
So what do you think happens next? It's a stampede. Everybody wants that inflation insurance policy we were talking about. So they start dumping their risky nominal bonds and snapping up those protected index bonds as fast as they possibly can.
And the effect is immediate. All that demand for the index bonds and the sell-off of the nominal ones, it changes their yields. That gap between the two widens almost instantly. And just like that, our secret code, our decoded number, it changes, revealing a brand new, much higher inflation expectation for the whole world to see. It's literally a live feed of economic anxiety.
Okay, so let's quickly recap the key takeaways here. First, we know the bond market has this hidden, secret code about future inflation. Second, we learned how to crack it. It's just the gap between what those nominal and indexed bonds are paying. Third, and this is the big one, you can use this number to make your own investment bets. And finally, remember that this isn't a static thing. It's a live indicator, reflecting the market's mood in real time.
Which really just leaves us with one last thought. You now have the key. You know how to read the market's mind. So the question isn't just about what some expert on TV is saying anymore. The real question is, what is the market, that massive wisdom of the crowd, predicting right now? The answer is out there. It's updated every single day, just waiting for you to go and look.